Hi everybody, Lebanon Now Shumi here, and I just wanted you to come on here and do a quick video, or as quick as possible, about a few items I've picked up over the last 6 or 7 days to care for my hair since I'm color treated now. So first, if you have a close up on my hair, this is how it's looking still. I'm still loving the color. This is a twist out. This twist out was done last week, so I took the twist out on Thursday. So I've had this twist out for what, 7, 8 days. Dyed my hair 9 days ago. Again, like I said, I'm still loving my hair, but I noticed that my hair is not as soft as it was before I color treated my hair. And I knew I needed to switch products to care for my color treated hair. I asked for suggestions in my last video, but I didn't see anyone suggest anything or any line of products to try. And so I did an online search for recommendations on how to care for color treated natural hair, and was given some suggestions through Google search. But first I want to talk about a couple of products I got prior to coloring my hair. One of the things I received was a Live Locks Honey Lock and Retwist Gel. This is something I want to try. Curly New Growth, Miss Island Spice, and Supernatural Beauty 87 all spoke about this product within the last 6 months in their videos. And this is the consistency. It's a kind of jelly putty type of consistency. I have not tried it yet, but I do plan to try it today. And the day that I dyed my hair, the night before, I was a little bit nervous about just using the tube of that relaxing natural intensive deep conditioner that comes with that Textures and Tones color. So I went and I bought the Argan Oil Intensive Conditioning Treatment, because I already had a leave-in conditioner for this. And so this was something I used as part of coloring my hair, and I think I mentioned it in the previous video. Now, there are two, well, there's one product line that I decided to start using to help moisturize my hair, to, you know, just kind of soften it up since I've colored my hair. Sorry, I don't know what's wrong with me. So I decided, I've tried Shea Moisture before, and I did the coconut and hibiscus line back in the day, and I ended up doing a giveaway with those products. But I ordered, not ordered, I got the Raw Shea Butter Restorative Conditioner and Shampoo, because specifically it says it's for dry damaged hair, and it's sulfate free and it's color safe. So I figure since this is moisturizing, this is something that can help me moisturize my locks. But the one line of the Shea Moisture line that I really wanted was the Jamaican Black Castor Oil line. What attracted me to the line especially is because of the apple cider vinegar that's in it. Because of locks, you know, it can help with me having buildup in my locks. Sorry, I thought somebody was outside. So I went to 5 different CVS's. And those CVS's had the leave-in conditioner, which I did manage to buy this. And it had the Jamaican Black Castor Oil Strengthen, Grow, and Restore Styling Lotion. The Jamaican Black Castor Oil Strengthen, Grow, and Restore Edge Treatment. And then 3 out of the 5 I went to also had the Jamaican Black Castor Oil Grow and Restore Hair Serum. So none of them had the shampoo, so I'm gonna have to buy the shampoo off the website and have it shipped to me, because I'm not about to drive all over Phoenix to try to find this shampoo. I went to 5 different ones. After the 5th one, I was like, it's time to go home, honey, and I was done. So my plan, once I receive the shampoo, is I'm gonna rotate each week. Well, first of all, I'm gonna start washing my hair every week now. I will not retwist every week, and I'm gonna stop retwisting my whole head for a while. I noticed that when I retwist my whole head and I put them in the 2-strand twist to do my twist outs, because I don't want to use clips, I think it's not the gels that I've been using to make my scalp itch. I think it's my palm rolling that's been making my scalp itch. I think I described it to you before, like, right now it's still twisted, so there's no new growth. But so what I would do is I will comb from here to here to kind of comb all the hairs down, and I would retwist I mean, palm roll, palm roll, palm roll the whole lock. And I think by palm rolling all the way down the lock, it's making my actual root really, really tight. And you know when you have tight braids, you know how that feels, where it's itching and it just drives you crazy. So I'm going to try to learn to just comb it down, palm roll it once, and keep it moving. So basically, my goal over the next 2 months, I would say until graduation, October 25th, what? Anyway, every week from between now and the time I graduate from school, I'm just going to shampoo 1 week with the raw shea butter, second week with the Jamaican black castor oil, just keep rotating, retwist with the live locks, but only retwist the first two rolls and maybe like the two rolls at the nape of my neck, and just leave the rest alone for a while, let my hair rest. And then at the end of October, what I'll do is I'll do a full head retwist. And I'm thinking maybe every 3 months doing a full head retwist, but every 3 weeks maybe doing just the edges. Yeah, I think that's a good plan. That's it, you guys. So thanks so much for watching. Hope my video made sense, because for some reason I'm having trouble speaking today. And I will see y'all in the next video. Bye-bye.